Hi. Here we have a Dell Inspiron 15 laptop that factory doesn't have solid state drive. It's have the usual hard drive with 500 gigabytes. So we're gonna replace it with an SSD 480 gigabytes solid state drive. And here we're gonna show how it is done. These are the tools that we're gonna need: two small screwdrivers, a toothbrush to clean the fan when we're gonna open it, and guitar player for opening the plastics without breaking it. So here, let's see first from the bottom. First safety measures: always remove the battery. So let's see if we're gonna remove all the bolts from the bottom. It's always good way the screws to be the screwdrivers to be magnetic, so it won't fail the screws. And to notice the screws. How long are the screws from each piece? So this screw, we remove it from the hinge. It's a longer bolt, and this is smaller. It's marked M2L5. So this problem means that this screw is 2 millimeters thick and 5 millimeters long. So these are marked. Also this one, the same situation, M2L5. That's a clever trick. So these two are the same. This one is probably holding the optical drive. It's one of the smallest, like the smaller ones, M2L5. So now I'm gonna try to remove the optical drive. Yes, it's removed. This is like the bigger ones. This also like the bigger ones. Oops, sorry. Like bigger ones. This looks like the screw is broken. The bolt is turning on in place. It cannot be removed. Also, this one. So after we remove this hinge, we're gonna need to apply glue on the bolts. So we're gonna tighten the back together the laptop and assemble it. So these are all the screws from the bottom. So I now use this trick. Oops, I broke my guitar player. I try to remove the keyboard with the guitar player, so not damaging, but I'm breaking it this time. So I'm gonna try to with this. This is straight, trying to be careful doing this, not damaging the screen, so you can lean it back more. There we go. Here we have app marked, so when we're gonna attach again the keyboard, don't confuse the sides. So the keyboard is matched up, the parts that need to go up. There we go. So now there's one more optical cable. Detach also. have couple bolts that all are marked M2L5, so it means they're gonna be like this, the smaller ones. So I'm gonna group it like this. These are from the bottom, these are from the bottom, and this gonna be from the upper side. You probably didn't notice here how I group the screws. So these are from the upper side, these are from the bottom, the small ones, and these are from the bottom, big ones. So that back. So now all the screws are removed. So now I need to open up plastics. So the tricky part is here to see which plastics comes off. So here probably gonna be the bottom. Let me see. Forgotten bolt. Sorry about that. Just to mention again, here we have two more bolts that are stuck, that are turning in place. Okay, this side is fine, so continue to this side. So, need to be patient. So, after removing the bottom cover, I noticed that my camera had turned off. So, let's explain what's happened here. These are the two bolts that was broken. It was stuck in place, it's gone off with along with the hinge. So you need to remove this like this by grabbing using the screwdriver from the other side. So this is how the bottom. So this is from the side. Let me see if I can show. This piece should be here. Now we're gonna see how it's the right place to be, like this. Turning it, it's gonna see how it's best fit. Some glue. the same gonna do also with this. This should be here, but I'm not gonna add it first. Alright, some wool. So we've done some plastics here. We'd come to the point when this is the hard drive that we're gonna need to replace it. So let's all show here this MB, this flat cable, when the hard drive, which can connect the hard drive to the motherboard. We're gonna remove it like this, just to show. These bolts are from smaller, even smaller than before, so they're around 3 millimeters long. So I'm gonna keep it all butt bolts grouped. So here we have, let's show here. Here we have from the bottom. These are from the upper side. These are from the bottom, smaller from the bottom, and these are from the hard drive. Okay. For bolts holding the hard drive, the hard drive is bolted on a bracket. There are 4 bolts also here, and a connector that now it's easily removed. So this goes like this way, like this. These bolts are short but thick. Cannot miss it. I'm gonna leave it right here. So I'm gonna open this again, going like this way. And I'm removing. Go this position. The hard drive is Toshiba and goes from the factory. If your screwdriver is magnetic, then it's easier to add the bolt on the screwdriver than trying to set it in place with the hand. Screws. So now connector. After connecting hard drive, I'm gonna add some glue, take this in place. So I'm gonna add some glue here. And then try to fit the broken pieces to the place where they belong. Usually after the glue is hardened, I usually apply some more on the side to be stronger. try not to get inside. I'm not gonna can tighten the bolt correctly. So now I can add the hard drive. Everything seems fine. Now these four smaller bolts, the smallest bolts, them all. Now the smallest. So now you have completed the procedure of installing the hard drive, the SSD drive. So now we need to assemble the laptop and install the Windows programs. And the laptop should be very fast. So thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe. If you have any questions, you can contact me on my YouTube channel or my blog. And if you like some tutorial that you think that I can add it to my channel, please write that also. Thanks again. Hi again. So decide not to shorten my video. Instead, I applied some glue on the broken pieces. Did you notice this? But this piece that comes with this part actually here, no, with this side actually here, need to belong to this. So I applied some glue here also. So now everything is like it should be. We clean out the keyboard. I use also a toothbrush. Is it like this, gently around every button. Please do the job. When it's open, I see that the fan doesn't have any dust. I clean it up a little bit also. So now I'm gonna begin with assembly of the laptop. Some bits of dust here. Clean this also. So this is the flat cable that can be forgotten around here. So try to squeeze it in the opening. So first on the hinges. There we go. Just to press a little bit. Now gently with the hinges. I missed the opening. It's supposed to be like this. There we go. This flat cable connects the optical drive to the connector. So now everything seems in place. Try to press. Not on the screen. And like this. You see the gaps from every thing. Mm-hmm. it's fine. So now we'll begin with the bottom, because there are bigger bolts, they're gonna tighten the laptop better. These two was broken, so we're gonna try not to tighten this so hard. Now, before tighten this screw, I inserted the optical drive, so it gets in much easier. Tighten first the optical. Just to mention here, this is a smaller bolt here. I'm also gonna add these two smaller bolts. Okay, and we're done. So this. Done. So, as I said before, the up mark part goes on the top. There we go. Check one more time. Places that gets 7 clips that holds the keyboard. Now we add the battery and we can start the laptop. This is the BIOS on the laptop. System operation. Set operation, always check it's HICI drives 480 GB Kingston. This is the correct what we want. So after that, connect the BIOS, add Samsung installation, USB drive, installing Windows 10, and we're ready to roll. Thanks again for watching.